Jesus School. We'd just like to welcome all of our online viewers here to Jesus School. Thank you for joining us here for our Thursday morning worship and communion. And so everyone online, everyone in the room, if you guys want to close your eyes, if you guys want to just put your attention, your affections on the Lord. And it says in Psalm 91, it says, "Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high because he has known my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation." And so, Lord, we set our love upon you. Lord, we set our affections upon you. Lord, we set our hearts and our eyes upon you, Jesus. Lord, we're so thankful, Jesus. We're so thankful, Lord. We're so thankful, and we do not forget your benefits. We thank you for cleansing our sins. We thank you for healing our bodies, Jesus. Lord, we come to adore you this morning. We've come to praise you this morning. We've come to give you the glory and the honor and the praise that you are due. Lord, you are so beautiful, God, and we're so thankful, Jesus. So, Lord, I pray that you are pleased with our worship this morning. We are pleased with this offering this morning. Jesus, we love you, we praise you, and we give you all the glory. Amen.
I will show. getting dignified today. Some may say it's foolishness, but I'll become even more dignified
than for you, Jesus.
Thanksgiving, just come out. Lord, we thank you.
Oh, thank
you. You're worthy,
Lord. Oh, thank you.
You're worthy.
Oh, you've been good.
So good.
Oh,
you've been so good. You've been so good.
Oh, thank
you've been so good. You've been so good. Thank you. Thanksgiving praise.
You're the peace in all distress. You're the light that breaks the darkness. You're the mighty one, the risen sun. You're the savior to the drowning. I was lost till you found me. You broke the chains that have bound me. You're the mighty one, the risen sun. You're the father to the fatherless. Oh, you're the peace in all distress. You're the light that breaks the darkness. You're the mighty one, the risen sun. You're the savior to the drowning. Oh, I was lost till you found me. You broke the chains that have bound me. You're the mighty one, the risen sun. You're the father to the fatherless. You're the peace in all distress. You're the light that breaks the darkness. You're the mighty one, the risen sun. You're the savior to the drowning. I was lost till you found me. You broke the chains that have bound me.
You're the mighty one that risen.
time you've been a good father, every time you've come, we'll remember. We'll remember, Jesus. We'll remember you hanging on the cross. We'll remember, Lord, when you took us from death to life, Lord. We remember, Jesus.
It's our honor this morning to come into your presence, Lord, and to worship you, Lord. It is our privilege and our joy to lift our voices, to lift our hearts in adoration to you, King Jesus. We thank you this morning for your presence, Lord. We thank you for your life in this room. You are forever worthy, and we thank you this morning, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. If you just want to make your way back to your seats, we're going to come to the table of the Lord as a Jesus School family. And if you're watching online and you just want to prepare your elements, we invite you to join us at the table of the Lord this morning. You just want to look at Jesus and take the bread. I'm going to read from Romans 8, starting in verse 1. Therefore, there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set you free from the law of sin and of death. For what the law could not do, weak as it was through the flesh, God did, sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and as an offering for sin, he condemned sin in the flesh. So Lord, we come to the table this morning to remember, to proclaim, to receive and partake of, and to thank you, Jesus, for the new and living way that was inaugurated through the tearing of your flesh, Lord. The new and living way that has put an end to sin, that has put an end to death, and that has brought us into life eternal,
into relationship, into union with you, King Jesus. So we thank you, Lord, that you have put an end to the sting of death. You have put an end to sin. And our lawless deeds, Lord, you remember no more, Lord. Our sin you have removed from us as far as the east is from the west. And so today we thank you, Jesus, as your blood-bought people, Lord, we thank you for the new and the living way, Lord. The new and living way through the tearing of your flesh. And we even thank you this morning, Lord, that anyone in this room or watching online who has the effects of the law of sin and death in their body or in their mind, Lord, that Jesus, you paid it all. And so we thank you even now for an end of freedom from the effect of sin in the mind, a freedom from the effect of sin in the body, that cancer would go in the name of Jesus, that there would be a newness of life, Lord, in every person in this room and watching online, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that by the bruising of your heel, you have crushed the serpent, Lord. So we are victorious this morning and we receive your victory and your life in Jesus' name. Amen. You can receive.
Jesus, our great Redeemer, we still our hearts before you and we thank you for your forgiveness. Open the eyes of our heart to see the beauty and the glory of this cup. I'm going to read from Colossians 1, 13. He has delivered us from the power of darkness and conveyed us into the kingdom of the Son of his love, in whom we have the redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins. And so, Lord, we do thank you that we are your redeemed, that at that moment of salvation that you washed us and cleansed us with your blood, that we can come boldly before your throne and obtain mercy and grace in our time of need. And we thank you, Lord, for the mystery and the beauty of the gospel, that we can confess our sin and you're faithful and just to forgive us of our sin and cleanse us again, Lord. And that, Lord, you say that as we forgive others, that you forgive us. So I ask, Holy Spirit, right now that you would hover over our hearts. If there is anything to confess to you, Father, that we would do it. Anyone to forgive, to release to you, God. You've shown us the true path of life. It is lowliness. It is forgiveness. You said, Father, forgive them. They know not what they do. And so, Father, we desire to be like you, to be perfect as you are perfect. And we receive your blood this morning, Lord. As redeemed sons and daughters, we thank you. You may receive the blood.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your presence, Lord. Thank you that you're here. We honor you in this place. We love you, Jesus. Let's turn to Luke 5. We're going to give to Jesus this morning. Amen. All right. I just kept hearing, they forsook all and followed him. So we're going to read about it in Luke 5 when he calls the disciples. We're going to start in verse 4. When he, speaking of Jesus, had stopped speaking, he said to Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a catch. But Simon answered and said to him, Master, we have toiled all night and caught nothing. Nevertheless, at your word, I will let down the net. I just loved that obedience. Like, you said it, I'll do it. And when they had done this, they caught a great number of fish, and their net was breaking. So they signaled to their partners in the other boat to come and help them, and they came and filled both the boats so that they began to sink. Like, they had probably never seen so many fish in their life. And Simon Peter saw it. He fell down at Jesus' knees and saying, Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord. For he and all who were with him were astonished at the catch of the fish which they had taken. And so also were James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were partners with Simon. And Jesus said to Simon, Do not be afraid. From now on you will catch men. Or other gospel translations say, I will make you fishers of men. So when they had brought their boats to land, this is the part, they forsook all and followed him. And I just, yeah, that just kept sticking out to me. They forsook all and followed him. And I was thinking of just what that meant to them at that time. Like, they come, they toiled all night trying to catch fish. Jesus comes in. He says, Can I teach on this boat? I didn't read that part, but can I teach on this boat? They see this man. And then he says, Do this. They obey. Then they get all of this fish. And then they leave the fish. And they follow him. And it just kind of was like, whoa, like, they didn't, that was probably the greatest miracle they had probably seen up until that point. They saw many more after that, we know. But they left it and they followed him. In other gospels, it says, like for James and John, it says they left their father in the boat. And they were like, we're following Jesus. And that concept of forsaking all, even I looked up that word, and one of the definitions is to yield up. And I was thinking, even for us as a school, we're heading into the summer, and I know I've been talking to a lot of students about, hey, like, remember why you came. Like, remember, you came for him. Don't check out now. And why is it so hard in finances, you know, to, like, I feel like that's why the Lord constantly is telling us, give, like, give to me, trust me, because it's hard. It's hard. And so maybe even in coming here, you're like, I gave all to come. And then somewhere along the way, you started kind of holding on again. And I just felt that for us, that yielding up and giving to the Lord today. And I'm just yielding up to you, Lord, what I've tried to hold on to. And I just want to trust you. I just want to trust you. And I just want to believe with you guys today, as we give to the Lord, that he is faithful and you can trust him. So Jesus, we thank you, Lord, that our lives are not our own. Lord, that we just came to give all to you, to yield up everything to you because you're worthy. So we thank you that that will show up in every single area of our lives, Lord, that it won't, we won't just be hearers of the word, but we'll be doers of the word, Lord, and be obedient to what you're asking us to do. Thank you, Lord, that we can give so beautifully to your hands, Lord, and know that you're trustworthy, and know that you're worthy, and know that you're good. So thank you, Lord, that our money doesn't even belong to us. It belongs to you. So we give it to you freely in trust and in faith this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. If you're in the room and you'd like to give by cash or check, you can raise your hand for an envelope and we'll bring the buckets up for you. If you're joining us online, there's a number on your screen and there's a number in this room as well if you're here by, want to give by phone. But we just want to thank our online viewers this morning. Thank you for joining us. We love you guys and we'll see you on Sunday morning at 10 a.m.
We believe that the nations will descend on this land.
That the sick will be healed here.
That the lost will be saved here.
That the presence of the glory of God will rest here.
Oh, that you would rend the heavens and come down, that the mountains might shake at your presence.
That the gospel will go forth from here,
shaking the earth for the glory of God.
That the presence of Jesus Christ would dwell among us.
Here we will enter into the peace of your presence. Here we will remain. Jesus said, remain in me and I in you.
Here we will remain.
This is holy ground.
where only one thing is needed, Jesus.
May Jesus be pleased with all that takes place here. May he be adored and worshiped here. May his word be taught in clarity and love here.
As we tell the generations to come the praises of the Lord and his strength and his wonderful works he has done.
May the generations come to find him here.
To find Jesus here.
Here.
Together we will build the house of God.
And a home for his people.